Good morning. It's quarter past five and relatively early in the morning. I had a dream, not this last night, but one or two nights before that, and I want to share it with you. I think it was a very eye-opening dream, and it is important to understand, and I believe I understand what it meant when Jesus was talking to me. But let me explain from the beginning. So the dream was like I was on a kind of cruise ship. There were many other people on the cruise ship as well, and it seemed like a holiday cruise or something like that, because everybody was in a nice, happy mood or so, as you would be on a cruise ship when you're on holidays, on vacation. But far in the distance there, we have seen that storm front coming ahead towards us, and it didn't look very, very scary from that point where we have been. We just knew there's something ahead of us. We still had a lot of fun and everything was nice, and when that storm front hit us, then everybody was panicking, and there was a lot of wind and storm, and everybody was crying out, praying and being afraid, and this kind of things, what you would imagine would happen when a crazy natural catastrophe would hit you, right? So the interesting thing here was, I was, while that storm was hitting, through the wind, I was lifted up into the air. And I could see from that position where I was down to that ship, and see the panic on that ship, and everything what was happening there. And then Jesus appeared beside me, and there was a very peaceful atmosphere with Jesus. And I said to him, "Those people there, they are crying out to you, they are praying." So I wanted to probably say they want that you save them. And the only thing Jesus said to me was a question, only two words. He was saying, "Are they?" And I knew in God's presence, the rapture would be very, very nearby. So there was this expectation that we would like go up into the sky, and I knew that I was just waiting. And at one point I was like lifted up into the sky, and then while I was lifted up into the sky, I saw there were many other peoples which I have not been have not seen before, were also lifted up into the sky with me, and I knew we would meet up there, and that was the end of the dream. So this two words, these questions, are they? This stuck with me the whole time. You know, when God speaks, it is like a hammer. Like it could be like you have to deliver a message, and your heart is beating the whole time, and it will stop to beat until you have delivered the message. Or in my case now, at this time, this two words, these questions, are they? It was stuck in my head, and I heard his words all the time. Are they? Are they? And I was thinking a lot about what does he mean, and for me it sounded like he decided not to listen to those prayers. And this can have many reasons. I think there are Bible verses who say, when you pray or cry out, I'm not going to listen. And I was thinking, actually, we are living in crazy times. Jesus says about the church in Thyatira that they are very, very, I'm paraphrasing now, I don't know exactly, I don't have a Bible here right now. That they are very diligent church. They are working, and the last works are more than the former works, and They seem to be a very good church and very good people, right? But they have tolerated Jezebel. And he says, if you do not repent, I throw you on a deathbed. So repent quickly. This was also what I was thinking about. If you do not repent, he's not going to listen to your cries for mercy and help. And this is what I get from it. If there's anything to repent from, repent, that means to turn around 180 degrees. You went in one direction and now you go back 180 degrees back. This can mean all kinds of sinful behavior, something you never came out from. But if the Holy Spirit convicts you of sin while you listen to it, do not hide it, because God knows anyway what is going on in your life. He knows what is going on in my life, right? Last year I had to repent from a sin, and it was not nice. I confessed it before God, and I didn't have peace at all in my heart. And I understood, like, there was always this knowing inside of me, it is not enough that I just confess it before God. And he wanted me that I confess my sin also in front of my wife. And I just thought I don't manage. And I was praying, and I was, oh, I don't manage. But after a week or so, after fighting with myself a week long or so, I decided to tell her, and it was not nice. And I still didn't have peace. So I didn't understand. So I confessed, and I wanted to get rid of it. And I said to God, I just want to be a faithful servant. And he made me understand by listening to a worship song that he desires a relationship. That album I was listening to is called, I believe, The Inner Room by a priest or a monk. He's called John Michael Talbot. And I was listening to it, and it gave me so much peace, The Inner Room. And I think this is what he wanted to make me understand. It's about a relationship between me and God, and that I'm alone with him. Yes, so this was a dream, and I believe if there's anything to repent from, the time is absolutely now. Jesus gives that example of the five foolish and the five wise virgins, right? And, sorry. So there will be a time when it's too late to repent. If you have to fill up your lamps with oil, do it now. I think this is a very important thing to do. God bless you and have a nice day.